and a woman. A man and a woman in a lab. Both had fled from the world. In their hand was a spherical structure, roundish like the real world. The head of a former engineer, doctor, and a part-time writer. He had engineered war, treated his comrades during the struggle. During the night, when his fellow comrades would find comfort in the beds of fair women, he would lead his bow and write about the events of the day and how they could fight in the coming days. Now that he was gone, the only thing they were left with was this hair, the hair they equated to a world. For in it, they believed the answers that the world needs are locked in it. The man looked at the window and said, "Our task is accomplished." It was an easy task. We should take a man from the street, promise him a large sum of money, and promise him that you will be in the next edition of the Guinness Book of Records. Once he agrees, we'll take this hair and insert it on his neck. Once the body comes to life, we'll interrogate till we're satisfied. Then we'll remove it and keep it for preservation. We might also keep it on him for a lifetime. We'll deny inheriting the hair of a hero. The woman. It would be an honor indeed, carrying the head of a finger. Sterilize my scissors. Drink some anesthetic. Rather, don't drink. You have inhaled a lot of it. It is in your bloodstream. Open the collar buttons. Close your eyes. Within a few minutes, we'll be legends, said the woman. The next one is a poem. It is entitled, Alone in a Room. Alone in a room, reciting a piece of literature. Tired of begging for a stage, she uses her pen as a mic, her desk as a podium. Suddenly, the cruel wolves open their ears. The more she utters, the more they crack. If the room collapses, the roof will crush her head, her mic will choke her, the desk will break her legs, the roof and the floor will sandwich her. I am worried about the head. Literature is a medicine. It pacifies her. She finds solace in it. It is the kind of husband that she can divorce. All her hope is in her voice. She needs nothing more than being heard by man and woman, or then she is becoming insane, alone in a room. Yes. And the third one is entitled, What Happens? What happens if the wind blows and finds nothing to blow? If the dead arise and find the living dead? And then the fourth one, Under the flyover. Separated by a meter in tires, two sons of this world drain poison on empty stomach. Call the police, call the police. I'm sorry, we only attend to criminals. Call the ambulance, call the ambulance. I'm sorry, we only attend to the sick. Separated by a meter in tires, two sons of this world drain poison on empty stomachs. When Uncle Thomas makes a piece of art, when Uncle Thomas makes a piece of art. There is an idea in his mind. Keeping this idea in his brain is a burden. He knows it is a passion. Tries to stick to an artistic vision. He modifies and remodifies the artwork. Children are born. Some die and some grow to become kings. The piece of art has evolved. He looks at it and hires a valuer. And then he is offered less. And then he goes on and on. The last one is entitled The Conversion of Uncle Jack. From Limpopo, he came with a spear in his arm. Aggression was in his nails. Killing to regain lost victory was the idea. Murder was all he had in his mind. From Limpopo to this place.
Oh, that's the end of the year.
C'était très bien, franchement, super.
Well, so now we have